Alright, YouTube, David Harry here, and in this video I'm going to be fooling around with some 8K 60 frames per second footage inside LumaFusion on one of these new Mac M1 Max MacBook Pro things. Now this one's got 32 gigabytes of static RAM and also 32 of those cores for the GPU. Okay, so let me just go full screen on LumaFusion here. Now, thing to bear in mind here are a couple of things. One, I am not a video editor. I've got friends who are video editors, like my good friend Hutchie. He's a proper video editor. I'm not. Also, I'm not really that good on LumaFusion either. There's tons of stuff I don't know about it. However, it's things that I'm going to do here are going to be stuff that's like within my grasp, but hopefully things that will impress people as far as the power of LumaFusion. Feel the power LumaFusion's offering you here, YouTube. Also, as well, I hate trackpads. What it was, I was hoping that when, like, you know, Apple come out with these new Macs, they were going to do the Mac Mini version. That didn't happen, so I've had to go for one of these MacBook things. And yes, I'm just not a fan of trackpads, and I forgot to attach my mouse before I started the video. What an idiot. Okay, so first thing here then, let's have a look at the project settings. So 60 frames per second, 16:9, and we're in Rec 709. 10-bit. Also, preferences here, let's run down here. So we are on the bestest possible quality as well. So effectively, we're trying to like really stress what we're about to do here. So best quality and all the rest of it. Let's see. And also as well, just a thing to mention here. Although the media is 8K, LumaFusion itself, if it's exactly the same today as it was yesterday, is that's 4K. So the timeline here is UHD 4K, but the media is going to be 8K. Now the thing with that is that within itself is actually quite a difficult task for a lot of editors, because we're having to downscale here. So this is something else that you have to consider as far as like applying stress to the mix is concerned. And very conveniently, I have a folder up here with media in, although I'm gonna have to go traipsing through this. I should have just already have had this one prepared. What an idiot. Okay, so ProRes, yay. Now let me just drop this file down to the timeline. Oh, before I just jump into this, if you have a look up here, it's gonna tell us the attribute to these files. So as you can see, 8K UHD 16:9. I'll just shorthand everything here to 4K and 8K. We know it's UHD and stuff like that. Okay, so there we go. Bit of 8K 60 media in the timeline for 4K 60 projects. So let's just see what happens here. Boom. Oh, YouTube, look at that. Oh, that's really nice. Let me just go full screen with that. Oh, lovely. That's, that's great, isn't it? I like that. Now, just while this is playing, just quickly as well, as I go through this little video, you may notice the odd little kind of like frame judder or something, right? Have to say, that is not LumaFusion. You might see stuff as I go around these corners here as well. See like that there. Every now and then you might see something. What it is, there's actually a couple of little drop frames within the recording. This is off the PS5, and the PS5 just couldn't keep up with some of the rendering at certain points during this sequence. So anything that you see that is like temporally weird, it is not LumaFusion, okay? It is like just there as well. There was some stuff, it is actually inherent within the source media. However, for the best part, that's just going to play through mad as hell, 60 frames per second, as we can see. So that there is mega impressive. Now, some people are going to be sitting there going, but hold on a minute, Dave, you know, this is one of those new Macs. We should not be getting surprised that it's doing this. Well, yes, that's correct. However, just because a piece of hardware is new, it doesn't mean to say that all the software that you're going to run on it is going to be perfect. And this is the reason why I'm doing this. And it's just to see if LumaFusion can take advantage of the hardware. And so far, that is a big fat yes. All right. Now, that's not to say that it's going to absolutely, like, you know, chug through all of the extra elements that's within the SoC here, you know, to do with all the encode, decode and stuff, which is in hardware. I don't know about that just yet. However, what we're seeing straight away is at least the benefit of the CPU being increased here. Okay, so what I'm going to do now is start doing some mad stuff, because I like mad stuff. Right, so let me go down and start mad stuff here. Let me take that to right round there. So let me do a cut there. So what I'm going to start doing now is some picture-in-picture things and stuff like that. So let me just get this here. Hold on. If I just pop that up there. So basically what we're going to do is sit a piece above another and then do a picture-in-picture. I'll just try and line some stuff up here as well, because I may end up having to look at these cut points to make other cut decisions. So let me just neaten that up a little bit there. Okay. And okay. Right. Now we're somewhere where I can start doing some crazy things. Now, bear in mind, I might screw a few things up here and there. If I double click this, oh, it's dropped the audio down there. I knew I'd get that wrong. Let me try that again. Double click. Oh, there we go. Hey, suddenly I'm an editor. All right. So now we are in that thing where we can alter geometry and all kinds of crazy things. And I'm not going to go for a straight, boring picture in picture. I'm just going to actually mess the geometry up of that clip as well. Look at that. How clever am I? Okay, so what I'm going to do is go back here. And as we can see, screwed up picture on the left-hand side. Nice picture for the best part. Oh, no, right side. Left side's the other one. Dave, you can't tell your left from your right, mate. Okay, look at this. Ooh. Oh, bask in the glory, YouTube. Check that out. That's amazing. Okay, right. That seems to be playing extremely well, I think. Like I say, we might see the odd little glitchy thing. It is within the media, not within LumaFusion. Now what I'm going to do is let's go and take another piece of the clip down here. Now, this is where it probably might struggle here, to be honest. And there's a probably a good reason for that, which I will explain momentarily. So let me just pop that up there. And then what I'll do, I will just get the end of that and extend it out. What it is, I know all this looks like it's like over long sections, but to be honest, you have to do this. You have to use long sections in order to be able to get a good gauge as to when things are messing up properly or not. Okay, and then once again with this, as long as I don't do that thing where it turns it into an audio track or it adds the audio track, yay, look at this, I'm a super editor now. Right, what I'm going to do is another picture in picture. This time I'll constrain the proportions and I'll put that up into the top left there. Oh, in fact, you know what? There's probably a preset for that, isn't there? Right, I missed that trick, didn't I? Okay, so two pictures in pictures here over this base layer. Let's see if it can handle it. Okay. Oh, no. Oh, look at that. It all failed. Or did it? Right, here's the thing at this point. I don't know whether LumaFusion is taking advantage of the accelerator engines in here. Now, people are going to remember that Apple was saying, yes, if you're in 4K, you can do a zillion tracks. And if you're in 8K, you can only do a billion. Right, the thing is here, when Apple start giving out those figures of, like, you know, so many, like 3 or 4 or 5, 6, 7, like, you know, it, you know, kind of like, tracks playing at the same time being edited and things, they're highly likely to be referring to 24 frames per second. Right now we're using 60 frames per second 8K here, so don't forget, one stream of 60 frames per second 8K is more than twice the processing power for doing two streams at 24 frames per second. Okay, so effectively right there we've been somewhere, let's see, 2, 4, 6, probably somewhere in the region of 8 streams of 8K 24, that would be the equivalent of within process and power. So it definitely would have fallen flat on its face, I think. And I think it would have done this anyway if it had used 24 frame per second media inside FCP, if it had, like, you know, overloaded this as it were. Basically what we're talking about when we talk about things like that, we're talking about bit rate and quite possibly pixel density, because the pixel density obviously does kind of linearly increase as you go up with the actual frame rates and stuff within the same resolution. However, Dave, shut your face, no one's interested. Right, what I'm going to do here, I'm just going to delete this clip. Right, now what I'm going to try here, because I've got a feeling this might work, I'm going to go back here and I'm going to pick an 8K file, but this time I'm going to pick H265, okay? Oh, the other thing as well, people may have already noticed here as well that I'm using the same clip to put over itself, right? And some people might be thinking, but hold on, that's wrong, isn't it? No, it's not. It just doesn't matter. It's just a bunch of zeros and ones. Doesn't matter if it comes from the same clip. In fact, if this were, say, on traditional spinning discs, this would be difficult to do because it'd have to keep reading the same place constantly over and over. However, we're basically on, like, you know, some of the fastest SSDs in the market at the moment as far as the Macs are concerned. So as far as actual disk access time is concerned, it is not an issue. Okay, so what I'm going to do here is go up to one of these clips here. As we can see, 8K. Now this is H265420 stuff here. And anyone who uses these things knows that these are not the easiest things in the world to handle. I mean, they are on Macs, funny enough, but on PC or on Windows PC. Actually, there's a distinction there. Mac and PC, it's all PCs, you know what I mean? So Windows or Mac, doesn't matter, they're all PCs. However, Mac PCs tend to handle these things better than their Windows PCs. And the reason for that is because there tends to be hardware associated on, you know, with the SOC and stuff to do decoding and things of that nature. Anyways, Dave, shut up, you're getting mega boring now. Right, okay, so let me just go into here. Hold on. Double tap that. Oh, look at that. I got that right three times in a row now. I'm a serious editor. Oh, look at that. Let me just pull it off the screen there. Actually, no. Let me do some weird geometry, hopefully. Hold on. Oh, there we go. Weird geometry again. In fact, you know what I'm going to do? I'm going to squeeze this crazy thin there. And let me just slap it into the middle of the screen. So we definitely can see that. We know that that's doing something. Now let me just go back and start that here. So there we go. Oh, it took a little bit of a sticky point there. However, oh, YouTube, look at that. All right. Now, the thing is here, I know people probably think, but Dave, you're just a mad tool, do you know what I mean? That might be so, but, you know, I'm not too mad as to not know how impressive this is. Let me just go to this again. Like I say, there are going to be the odd little weird things as I go around this corner. It's inherent within the file, but this is insane. This is three streams of 8K60, two of which are like being madly weirdly messed up as far as the geometry is concerned. This is mad. Let's see. Yeah, a little screw up there. I think that's the buffer filling as well. But once it's past there, it looks okay. What it is, I'm looking on an external monitor here, so I'm having to keep moving my head backwards and forwards. I might be missing stuff as I'm turning around. Hold on. Yeah, do you know what? I don't care what, you know, however you look at this. This is crazy impressive. Now, let's see. I'm 12 minutes into this video. Oh, dear. I just don't know when to shut my trap, do I? Okay, right. Let me just try a couple of quick things here. So, the base layer here. Let's see, where is the color thing? Is this color thing? There's color thing there. Okay, so I'm gonna totally blow out all the colors in that base layer and just go mental with it. Hold on. What I'm doing here, I'm just doing stuff so we definitely can see that something's changed in that base layer. I don't think anyone's confusing what the base layer is doing there. It's totally messed up. Hold on. Okay, there we go. Look at that for a grade. Now, if anyone out there has got like a really serious project on the go and they need someone to finish it, give me a shout. Let's have a look at this. Okay, still a little bit of like weirdness as I go around that corner. I think that is the file. But look at that. Oh, that is just bizarre, isn't it? Look at that. Oh, that's, yeah. Okay, there's no words. No words can truly convey my feelings right now for what's going on here. I'm totally blown away. Okay, now, just last thing. Let me try and mess this up a bit more. Let me go to here, and let me pick something else. So what we're doing, we're going to just screw about now with the what's-her-name, with the H265 clip that I popped in. So as we can see, totally messed up. There's no way we're going to mistake. Oh, that's even better. Yeah, we can definitely see that. Look at this. My color grading is amazing, isn't it, YouTube? Right, like I say, I'm free for parties as well for doing this stuff. Here we go. Wow. Right. I don't know what to say there. That is just nuts. Look at that. That is just absolutely fantastic. Right, very last thing. I always say this is the last thing every time I do something like this, and I'm a big fat liar. But what I'm going to try here, let me see. Right, I've never tried this before. Right, I might have to do a jump cut here in case I can't do it because I'm a total tool. Right, so how do I add a keyframe here? Hold on. Haha, it would appear that I'm only a bit of a tool. I think I might have worked out how to do the keyframes. Right, hold on a sec. So what I need to do, I've just inserted one keyframe. Let me just come down here to there. And then if I click that, does that add another keyframe there? Well, there's one there. Let me go back down to here. And then if I do that, there's one there. Okay, so let me go back to this keyframe up here. And then if I move that down there, then if I come back down here, does it go back to where it was? Yes, it does. Okay, so we've got a bit of tracking now on that layer. Let's see what happens here with that layer, see if it tracks across properly with the keyframe. Okay, I'm not entirely sure if that is super smooth. Yeah. Right, like I said, I don't know if that's entirely super smooth, but that is mega impressive. Anyway, look, YouTube, we're getting on for about 16, 17 minutes here, and I just don't know when to shut me trap, and I've got a cup of coffee going dead cold right now. Anyways, look, I've just shown you some stuff there to do with LumaFusion and like this, you know, 8K media and stuff. I think this is just absolutely insane. Now, whilst what I've been doing here is just a complete mess, it should give people a really good idea as to what they could get away with, you know, so somebody who can edit properly with LumaFusion, should we say, and not some tool like me. This should give you a very good idea as to what you can be doing with this. This is absolutely super awesome. Now, I've also got a playlist that I'm slowly building up over time to do with LumaFusion, so check that out in my playlists and all the rest of it. And maybe give us a thumbs up if you found the video insightful or entertaining or something, anything. If you've taken anything away positively from this video, please give it a thumbs up. Also as well, you may want to consider subscribing to my channel, and if you subscribe to the channel, you might as well click that bell notification icon thing. I'm David Harry. Thank you very much for watching this video. Take care and goodbye now.